How is it going, everybody? And welcome back to the Minecraft Let's Play. I am, of course, System Z, and you know what else I am? I'm standing in an empty room. And today, we are going to do something about that. We are going to decorate this room. We are in the cabin at the moment, as you can currently see, and this is the only room that has yet to be decorated, and I finally found a good way to do it. But anyways, in the last episode, we defeated the ocean monument, and we honestly did it with ease. It was definitely easy, and we have a lot of potions left over, so I've got them all stored in here. And as far as any loot, we really didn't get much, but we did get a couple of sponge. I'm saving those as well, but I definitely want to go back there and make a farm eventually. But honestly, the best thing about last episode has got to be the fact that we got wither skeleton skulls. That is amazing. If you missed it, go watch it. If you enjoyed the video and want to support my channel and help me make videos in the future, consider becoming a member, where you'll be invited to my Minecraft and Discord servers, as well as have a chance to help me with new videos through exclusive community posts. Click the join button below for more information, and also thank you to those of you who have become a member since my last video. But of course, today's Let's Play episode has absolutely nothing to do with the Wither. In fact, I really don't even know when we're gonna battle the Wither, so that's probably gonna take a little time. It'll definitely be after the dragon, but today is all about interior decoration and furniture, but more importantly, a data pack that I have found and I absolutely love. And I actually just got done doing a live stream about it. So all of you who are at the live stream, shout out to you guys. Thank you so much for watching. But you know exactly what I'm talking about. And that, of course, is the Armor Stands Data Pack by Stick God. But it's found on Exuma Void's website. Now, I love this data pack. And I've kind of debated whether or not I should use it on this particular world. But you're going to see exactly why I want to use it. So what I was thinking is, as far as decorating this room goes, we need to be able to get all of our tools and all of our armor off or on whenever we want. So I want to make sure that it's decorated in a way that we can actually walk up to the wall and grab an item. And I know what you may be thinking, how is that going to be possible? Well, it's all because of this book. Now here's the thing, I really value your opinion. I want to make sure that you're happy. So ultimately, let me know if you would rather me not do this, because honestly, if you would prefer I don't utilize this data pack, I'll definitely take all of this down. But I'm going to assume that you like it, because trust me, it's really cool. So just as an example, I'm going to make a little thing here, and I'm going to use this data pack to essentially hang up an item on the wall, and it's going to be awesome. It looks a little weird right now, but trust me, when I do this, oh yeah, look at that. That is amazing. I absolutely love this, and this is pretty much the core of this decoration process. It is going to be so cool, and it works. I can actually walk up to it. Now this isn't a mod, like I said, it's a data pack. Unfortunately, Java Edition only, but I know a lot of different Let's Players who use it, so please don't be mad at me, because it is really, really cool. But that being said, let's go grab a couple of items for this decoration. All right, I've got about everything I need, but before we continue talking about this data pack and we work on the furniture, we've got to sneak, because I've got to go steal something from a villager, and I really, really don't want them to see me, because they've got an iron golem, and as you can see, he's posted on the top, and we got to make sure he doesn't see us. So we gotta hide behind every building we possibly can. Now I'm looking for the cartography table because, simply put, I'm lazy. And I don't want to craft him. He spotted me. Okay, we gotta go. Oh, jeez. Okay, alright. We're in. So there's the cartography table. The prized possession. Oh, okay, that's the horse. That's fine. Let's go ahead and grab it. I don't feel like crafting one. They don't need it after all, so I'm just gonna steal it. I'm just gonna go around the corner. And it never happened. Okay, okay, let's go. Let's go. I'm really nervous about today's Let's Play episode, by the way. And I know you may be thinking, Z, why are you nervous? Well, I'm going to explain. The data pack. I live streamed the other day to 800 people, and they all said, yes, use the data pack. We really want you to use this data pack. It's super cool, and we understand. But the thing is the Let's Play episodes, or at least one of the recent ones, got 200,000 views. And that's a lot more than 800 people. So I'm expecting a little bit of a different reaction, but just remember, ultimately, if you don't want me to use it, I won't use it. If a majority of the people do not want me to use this data pack, I will get rid of it. But honestly, it's going to really allow ourselves to immerse into the game of building, and I think it's going to be amazing if we do get to use it. So please consider that as we build with it. It's really, really cool. I know it's Java Edition only, but it is going to be well worth it. Just wait until you see the design that I've got for this living room. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. We're not gonna need the sword, so let's put it up. I love it. Look, I love it. I can't keep talking about it, okay? It's amazing. Now, we're gonna need a couple of things for this living room. I want some sort of place to sit, even though I can't sit in the game. It's super sad, my feet hurt, but that's fine. I just want it for cosmetics. I also want a cartography table because we're going to need one eventually, or at least I think we will. We don't really have one and it just makes sense to put it there. Plus, it would be a great way to store this book in my hand, so it's perfect. Now, that being said, there's a couple of ways we could do this. It's kind of limited because of this stairwell, as you can see. And I also want to find a place to put a chest as well. So that being said, I think I'm going to go ahead and put the cartography table here. And I kind of want to get the decorations in place before we do anything with armor stands, because if we wait, then I might not be able to place them because armor stands might be blocking them. So that would be, of course, bad. But that being said, let's get into it. All right, that was close because I just noticed that right under there is our secret underground lair, but it looks like we're good. So yeah, all right. So for some lighting, I'm actually going to go use some glowstone for the potions, which is perfect. We're probably only going to need about two. So let's go ahead and do that. Now, I want to know, what is your absolute favorite room to decorate in Minecraft? Do you like to decorate bedrooms? Do you like to decorate kitchens, living rooms? Let me know, because I honestly love doing videos showcasing different designs. And if you've been watching for a long time, then you probably know that interior design is one of my favorite things about Minecraft. I absolutely love it. And by the way, another tip. The reason I'm using the cartography table really is because it's got papers on it. And it just kind of looks cool. It looks like a desk. So that's why I wanted to use it. But anyways, let's go ahead and get this sofa built. I want to show you exactly what I'm going to do for this. Or at least, no, I cannot. Because I don't have any snow on me. And I'm going to need to get some. But basically, we're going to do a bed. And we're going to use armor stands to essentially make it look like there's pillows. And it's going to be very cool and look amazing. But I'll go ahead and place those there. And I'm also going to surround it with some trap doors, which I've got here. I'm not used to not having my items in my inventory, so this is weird. But it's okay. We can actually go ahead and change this. I think we're going to do some of these here. I'm really bad when it comes to commentary on these sorts of things, but hopefully you still get something out of this. I love the way this final product is going to look. In my head, I've had this idea for a while, and it is going to look so awesome. Let's go ahead and get a little plant in the corner. You know we got to have that dead bush as the stem of the plant. It just looks so good. I love it so much, and I really don't like this, so let's get rid of that. Nope, definitely not going to need that. I'm going to put that there, maybe get some trap doors, and perfect. It is done. The entire room is complete. Just kidding. That would be pretty anticlimactic. By the way, you can actually do a sofa like this without the armor stands. I'm just going to put iron helmets here to make it look like pillows, but honestly, it works without it. It just looks a little bit better because of this part of the bed. But now that we've done that, I'm going to go ahead and get the rest of these placed. So to do that, we're going to need to lay out some ground blocks and, of course, get our armor stands placed with our trip hooks. Now, again, this is the main feature of this room. This is going to allow me to easily store and keep up with all of my important items. I'm also going to put some over here to store things like shields and bows and, of course, armor. But we need to do each of these individually. And just in case you want to use it, this is essentially how I do this. I basically do what you just saw. I click the buttons I click. And then, of course, in auto alignment, you can just do tool rack. But you've got to have a trip hook there. Very, very easy process, but very worth it because it is super cool. I just love the way this looks. It's one of the best things about this entire pack. It's amazing. And there we go. We've got the axe one done, or at least I thought we did. There we go. Come on. Please work. Don't fail me now. All right. Something has broke. Nope. There we go. Okay. That scared me a little bit. Looking good, looking good. And all I need to do now is find a place to put the book. But fortunately, I've already placed an armor stand over here. And now I can just get it perfectly sitting on the desk. And that, again, is just another example at why I really want to use this. I've wanted to use it since the beginning. It's just amazing. I love it so much. But now that we've got all that going, I need to find another place to put a light. And I'm thinking that right here will definitely work. And honestly, we could pretty much say that this is done because it looks perfectly fine as it is. Also, before I forget, when I streamed, a lot of people donated, and I just want to say special thank you to all of these people. You know who you are. Just figured since I had the book, I would do that. But now all we need to do is get one place for my armor, which we could go ahead and just put one there in the corner. This one doesn't have to be special or anything like that. Now, I do want to have one for a shield and my bow. The only problem with that is I really don't know where I would put it because I don't know if I want another one right beside it. But I guess at the very least, we can see what that would look like. The moment of truth, how does this look? It's all right. I just don't like the fact that the shield is facing this way. I feel like it would look better if it were the other way around, but I really can't be picky here. I'm already being very, very picky just by wanting to use this. We could also put it over here. That may work, but I feel like it might look a little weird. But at the very least, I can go up to it. I can grab everything I need. So it works, and that is all that matters. Let me just go ahead and get the final details put in because we are pretty much done. I might add a painting here, but I'm not entirely sure yet. But ultimately, it is looking awesome. So like I said, let me just get a couple of things together and we will look at the final product. Man, this data pack just keeps getting even better. I didn't even realize that I could make the armor stands invisible. So what I did is I essentially placed armor stands here, used some pistons to push the wood back, and then I made the armor stand invisible so that you don't even see it. I think that's awesome. But all I've done here is basically taken an iron helmet, and it looks like a pillow, and it just kind of covers up this part of the bed, so we get a nice little sofa design. I think this room looks awesome, and it's actually perfect for what we needed in this room. And the reason why is because think of it like this. Whenever we were preparing for the Ocean Monument raid, we had to store everything in here, and that's extremely limited. I was all over the place. I didn't have anywhere to put my items other than this chest and that barrel. And honestly, it's really cool and very nice to have a room dedicated to getting prepared. I've got this double chest so that anytime I want to prepare for something, I can just put them in here. Of course, I can store my tools on the wall and grab them as I need. I got my armor, I got my bow, I got my shield. Basically, any tools that I have, I can start keeping in here. And of course, if we're dealing with cartography and maps to go to, say, the Woodland Mansion, we can deal with it here. And then, of course, we've got our book for the statues. Now, this is the perfect room. And as a general building tip, this is why. Whenever you're building a room, if you can find a use for everything, every single decoration in there, then that's amazing. That is literally the perfect designed room, the perfectly designed room. And just an example, the chest, we store all of our items in here. We've got our armor and tools on the wall. We've got the cartography table, a place to store this book, a bed, so if we need to sleep down here, we can. Basically, everything has a use, and for that reason, it is perfect. But as much as I love the room, it is definitely good to finally get some fresh air. Oh my goodness, we have spent the entire episode inside, and I'm very sorry for that. Oh geez, we're being attacked. Oh no, I don't have any of my tools or armor. That was a bad decision. Very, very bad decision. So I'm gonna remember, or need to start remembering, to actually grab my items, because otherwise we're gonna be pretty bad. You know what? We really don't even need anything but our sword. And of course, I'll grab my armor so that we are safe. But this is why I love it. I can easily just get what I need. But anyways, back outside where we love the place. The skeleton's probably dead now. Yep. Did all of that for nothing. But as I was saying, it is time to finally prepare to do some of the more survival things in the game. Like getting the wolves inside. And by the way, I still haven't named them. Again, that's going to be the joke of the series. We're never going to name them. I know that's going to make some people upset though, so let's just pretend we did. Come on, thing one and thing two. But yeah, this guy's really stuck. Come on, buddy. You can go through the door. It's fine. You're not going to get hurt. Please? There we go. Looking good. Let's get him a little bit more scooted into the room there. I'll have to figure out a place for him. But for now, they're at least out of the rain. We are looking good to go. But I want to prepare for the more survival-friendly things. Or, well, not survival-friendly, but more survival-heavy things. Like, we need to battle the end. We need to essentially beat the dragon, battle the wither. There's a lot of things we got to do. Plus, there's jungle pyramids and desert pyramids. There's so many different things that we need to explore in the game. The Woodland Mansion, for example. So I really want to start getting the ball rolling on that. And I also want to start building in the new villages that I've had planned. Obviously, I do need to work on the jungle village, but I do plan on doing that on my own time because that's kind of a side village. But I really want to get started on some of the mega builds that I've got planned. But that's essentially going to be it for today's episode. I'm away on vacation at the moment, or at least I'm ending my vacation at this point, so I really didn't have time to prepare anything along. But you know what? We got some really cool progress done because I believe this cabin is officially finished. The only thing that I really want to do now is get this diamond hoe in my inventory. It was in my inventory. And place it somewhere back here. I'm not going to do it right now. I got to find a place to do it, but I think it would be awesome to have it hanging up like we do inside. But that is essentially it for this data pack. That's how you use it. I think it's amazing, and I would love to use it, but I'd really like your opinions as well, because I definitely value your opinions, and I will respect it. So if you'd rather me not use them, let me know. But ultimately, I think it's worth it. I think it looks amazing. And honestly, trip hooks just need to be able to do this anyways, because it makes sense. That's gonna be it for today's episode. Pretty much the only thing we have left on this cabin is custom trees and custom landscaping. So let me know if you'd like to see a video or an episode on that in the future. Let me know in the comments down below. But if you enjoyed, make sure to leave a thumbs up, consider subscribing and turning on notifications to be alerted whenever I next upload a video. And also, special thank you to those of you who've already done that. And also, hello to everybody at the premiere. I hope you enjoyed the episode today as well. But anyways, that is gonna be it for today. My name has been System Z. You guys have been awesome, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.